Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Iman Maksud, student of Electronics Engineering, Department of University of Engineering and Technology, Texila, and a member of research group named Syndicate of Embedded and Electronic Design SEED. Today, I am here to present you my research on variable scene classification system for visually impaired individuals. Let's see the contents that we will cover in this presentation. First of all, we will look at introduction. Then we will discuss some of the previous work cited. Then we will look at methods and materials. Then we will discuss results and discussion. Then comes conclusion and finally references. Most of the information and other cues of mobility are transferred to humans through complex sensory system. Hence, navigation is a highly challenging problem for visually impaired individuals. According to a survey made by World Health Organization, around 285 million individuals suffer from visual impairment. Of those, 35 million individuals are totally blind, and this population is expected to be double in coming decades. Another survey shows that around 30% of individuals die in accidents suffering from visual impairment or blindness. Since 1960s, efficient systems were developed to help visually impaired individuals, but their drawback is that they cannot detect speed and type of object. The aid for visually impaired individuals proposed in this study can do scene perception using audio and image processing. It tells the user not only about hurdles and obstacles, but also the distance of obstacles from the user. The output is conveyed to the user in the form of audio. Now let's discuss some of the previous work cited to overcome visual impairment challenge. In 2018, DCNN technique was used to develop a system for visually impaired individuals. The system used webcam INIT for image acquisition and then laser for distance measurement. This system uses outdoor scenes for classification and attained accuracy of 81.5%. Another system using optical flow techniques was proposed by UNIS in 2018. This system uses a monocular camera for image acquisition, and monitoring glasses were developed to help visually impaired individuals. When results were evaluated, the system achieved an accuracy of 84%. Hoge in 2016 used deep learning techniques to develop an aid for assisting visually impaired individuals. RGBD cameras were used to obtain depth data and 2D images. Output in the form of voice was communicated to user, and accuracy of 97.93% was achieved by this system. Indoor scenes classification system was designed in 2019 that uses Logitech camera to capture real-time images, which were then pre-processed using Hopf transform, and expected features were classified using fuzzy logic. The results were conveyed in the form of speech. This system gave an accuracy of 89.5%. In order to design an aid for visually impaired individuals, the first step we follow is hardware interfacing. Then data of images was acquired using hardware, which is then pre-processed. Features were extracted from the pre-processed images, which is at end classified using different classifiers. Our designs basically consist of Raspberry Pi 3 Plus 9PN camera for image acquisition, Raspberry Pi 3 Plus for processing of data, power bank, and microphone for conveying output in the form of audio to user. In order to interface hardware, we install Raspbian OS, then camera is interfaced with Raspberry Pi using Python. All these components were then assembled on chest bearing belt. The hardware and chest bearing belt can be seen in these figures. In next step, data was acquired using hardware we interface. Real-time indoor scenes data was acquired from 8 different classes. Data was acquired during daytime. Total of 800 images were acquired using night VN camera. Summary of acquired data can be seen in this table. Acquired images from different scenes can be seen in these figures. The images we acquired contains noise and motion artifacts, hence they need to be pre-processed. This is done using two techniques known as retinex filtering and low light image enhancement method. Let's discuss retinex filtering. In retinex filtering, color of image is made constant under varying illumination conditions. It makes color of image more sharp. It enhances dark and bright areas of image. After pre-processing using retinex filtering technique, the images can be seen like this. The acquired images were then further pre-processed using low light image enhancement method. In LIME technique, illumination of each pixel of an image is found. Then initial illumination map is refined by imposing structure on it. This technique is used for denoising and enhancing the visibility of an image. Images after pre-processing using LIME technique can be seen here. After pre-processing, local binary pattern features were extracted from pre-processed images to extract distinctive features from pre-processed images. These LBP features were extracted from both pre-processed images techniques. LBP features can be extracted from images using following steps. In step number 1, images divided into uniform binary patterns called local binary patterns. In step number 2, for each reference, center value is selected as a reference value. In next step, one value is placed for values higher than references and zero is placed for values lower than reference. Then binary form pattern is multiplied with general frequency component, which is then added to form a resultant value. In last step, these features from both techniques were fused and then classified using different performance classifiers, including quadratic discriminant classifier. Quadratic discriminant analysis is a type of classifier in which for every class of observations, a separate covariance matrix is estimated. In QDA, it is assumed that measurements from each class are normally distributed. QDA has usually larger number of effective parameters. The results obtained from classifier shows that maximum accuracy of 92% was obtained from quadratic discriminant classifier having an error rate of 8%. The confusion matrix of quadratic discriminant classifier is shown here. Evaluation parameters for different classifiers in terms of accuracy, sensitivity, specificity, and error rate can be seen here. It can be seen that fine-tree classifier give maximum error rate of 26.5% and maximum accuracy of 92% was attained by quadratic discriminant classifier. Hence, we can conclude that AID designed has low cost and least weight. It is portable and has easy algorithms implementation. This device is efficient in recognizing natural scenes for visually impaired individuals. In future, we can increase its computational efficiency by enhancing dataset without affecting the total execution time. The references of previous work cited can be seen here. Thank you.